to the St. Christopher's Board of Directors, our honoured guest, Dr. Jackie Cthulhu, parents, friends, pupils and fellow travellers, good morning and welcome to Speech Day 2023. This morning gives us an opportunity to reflect on the 2022-23 academic year and to celebrate the significant achievements of the SEIS pupils and also the school. Today we gather to celebrate our theme, Together on a Journey. It is a concept that resonates deeply within us as human beings, for we are interconnected on this vast voyage called life. And on this journey, it is the connections we make, the bonds we form, and the company that we keep that truly enrich our experiences. To begin our journey this morning, I will cast our minds back to August 11th, 2022, where our IGCSE and A-level candidates received their final examination results. It was naturally an anxious wait for our exam candidates as their final exams were marked and moderated by Cambridge. The SEIS staff remained confident, however, that the candidates' careful preparation would yield another year of success. As a non-selective school, we challenge each and every pupil at St. Christopher's to overcome any barriers that may stand in their way as they strive for excellence and ensure that they achieve their full potential. Through hard work, determination, and resilience, this cohort certainly did that. In the IGCSE exams, St. Christopher's maintained its excellent record with 80% of pupils achieving grades of A star to C and 41% of grades awarded A star to B. In A level, 22% of grades awarded were A star to A and 39% of grades were A star to B. In our BTEC program, 76% of grades awarded were distinction or merit and 100% pass rate for all candidates. Needless to say that we are thrilled with the performance of both our IGCSE and A-level candidates during this series. As we explore this SEIS journey of togetherness, it is critical that we take lessons from literature. Julia Donaldson, a beloved children's writer, has gifted us with stories that highlight the magic that unfolds when we embark on a journey with others. In her book, The Stick Man, Julia Donaldson tells the tale of a humble stick who finds himself separated from his family. Journeying through unfamiliar landscapes, along the way he encounters various characters who unwittingly help him find his way back home. This heartwarming story reminds us that even the seemingly insignificant can play a vital role in shaping our journey. It teaches us to value every connection that we make, for we never know when a simple encounter may lead to a profound impact on our lives. The World Scholars Competition is one such event that leaves a profound and lasting impact on the participants as they challenge themselves against pupils from around the globe with infinite new connections and encounters along the way. In August last year, having already qualified at the regional rounds, our World Scholars flew to Prague, where they competed in the global rounds. Here they were hoping to qualify for a spot in the round of champions, which was to take place at Yale University later that year. On their journey, as well as all three teams achieving qualification into the final round, they placed second in the collaborative writing challenge. Fast forward to November, at the round of champions, and not even I could have imagined the success stories our scholars would travel home with. A host of individual team medals were collected in various disciplines, and the junior team consisting of Christian Otieno, Nadia Korea, and Kesha Nawira eclipsed all expectations by achieving two remarkable feats in the team competition, where they came fourth in Africa and first in Kenya. As we traverse the winding roads of life, we encounter challenges that may seem insurmountable. Yet it is during these moments that the support of those around us becomes paramount. As the African proverb wisely says, if you want to go fast, go alone. If you want to go far, go together. This proverb is personified each term when St. Christopher's sports teams take the field together. With the emphasis on teamwork, collaboration, and collective effort, the SEIS sport program has achieved remarkable accomplishments which extend well beyond individual victories. Under 9 girls football, St. Christopher's were KAIS champions. Under 9 boys football, St. Christopher's were KAIS champions. Under 11 boys football, St. Christopher's were KAIS champions. Under 13 girls football, St. Christopher's were KAIS champions. Under 9 girls hockey, St. Christopher's were KAIS champions. The under 12 Brayside football competition, St. Christopher's again were champions. And the under 13 boys hockey, St. Christopher's were KAIS plate champions. And the under 15 boys hockey, St. Christopher's were KAIS champions. At the KAIS cross country competition, St. Christopher's were runners up by a single point. And for the first time ever, at the PIPSA National Swimming Gala, St. Christopher's were champions. Well done. Beyond the immediate victories on the field, the impact of the sports program extends into the broader school community. This program serves as a platform for personal growth, nurturing leadership skills and promoting a sense of belonging amongst our pupils. The achievements of these pupils inspire others to get involved in sports, fostering a culture of participation, healthy competition, and physical fitness. As a result, the sports program has become a catalyst for positive change at SCIS, promoting overall well-being and encouraging academic excellence as well. I would like to take this opportunity to thank Mr. Odingo and his team for their tremendous efforts this year. Turning our attention back to Donaldson Stickman, we learn that even the most seemingly ordinary amongst us can achieve extraordinary things when we embrace our uniqueness and connect with others. Each pupil in our school has a story to tell, talents to share, and dreams to pursue. It is no surprise, therefore, that the Creative Arts program has been an integral part of the pupils' education this year, enabling them to explore the depths of their artistic potential and discover the power of self-expression. Through visual arts, music, dance, theatre, and creative writing, we've had the privilege to embrace our individuality and to unleash our unique talents. The secondary production of Blood Brothers was truly magical. The actors brought an exceptional level of authenticity and emotion to their roles. The way they portrayed the complex characters and conveyed the intense emotions of the story was both captivating and deeply moving. The members of the cast demonstrated a remarkable understanding of their characters' motivations and delivered their lines with conviction and nuance. More recently, we were treated to the prep production of Robin and the Sherwood Hoodies. This was a truly outstanding performance that has left us spellbound and yearning for more. These performances were a testament to the power of the arts, the ability to uplift, inspire, and unite us all. You have given us a gift that transcends time and space, a shared experience that will be forever cherished. Tea time concerts, house harmonies, orchestral weekends, the list really does go on. The arts program has provided our pupils with a platform to showcase their creativity, to communicate thoughts and emotions in ways that words alone cannot express. The impact of the Creative Arts program extends far beyond the boundaries of our school. It enriches the lives and empowers us to view the world through a different lens. It fosters empathy, critical thinking, and problem-solving skills. It cultivates a sense of discipline, dedication, and teamwork. The arts transcend language, culture, and barriers, connecting us on a deeper level and fostering an understanding and unity. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank Mr. Watatua and Mr. Nyongesa and their teams for continuing to ignite the flame of creativity, imagination, and self-expression within each and every one of us. Ralph Emerson said, "Life is a journey, not a destination." Our ongoing association with the Council of International Schools and commitment to continuous improvement embodies this quote. We believe at SCIS that in order to properly prepare our children for an ever-evolving world, we must continue to evolve as a school on our journey of excellence. The CIS inspection was an integral part of this journey, and I'm extremely proud of the St. Christopher's success during their visit. CIS commented that St. Christopher's clearly demonstrates its commitment to upholding its guiding statements and providing and sustaining a high-quality learning experience, inclusive of all community members. CIS is pleased to inform St. Christopher's International School that it has been granted candidate status with CIS accreditation. These positive outcomes are testament to the collective efforts of our entire community, including staff, pupils, parents, and directors. I would like to express my heartfelt appreciation for your ongoing support in this endeavour as it plays a vital role in our success. At St. Christopher's, we firmly believe in nurturing well-rounded individuals who not only excel academically, but also develop empathy, compassion, and a deep understanding of the world. Our CSR initiatives this year have been an essential part of this vision, fostering a strong sense of community, engagement, and encouraging our pupils to become active contributors to society. This year, our pupils have rolled up their sleeves to make a difference in the lives of others, focusing on initiatives that support education, our environment, and the care of the elderly, culminating in a wonderful celebration of community service and art at our CSR Carnival, which brought together all of these wonderful initiatives. This year, St. Christopher's pupils have managed to raise 858,444 shillings to support the following initiatives: the Old Pajetta Rhino Project, Lion Lights, Compassionate Hands for the Disabled, Ngong Forest Primary School, Nyuma Nyawezi Little Sisters of the Poor, Amani Children's Home, Turtle Watch, Ghetto Classics, Greenbelt Movement, and the Heart to Heart Foundation. Well done. I could not conclude my speech without thanking all of those that allow St. Christopher's and its community to continue on this journey. First and foremost, I want to express my gratitude to the Board of Directors. Your tireless efforts, wisdom, and guidance have been instrumental in shaping vision and direction of our school. Your commitment to excellence and your unwavering support have created an environment that fosters growth and success. We appreciate the countless hours that you have dedicated in making strategic decisions, ensuring the welfare of our students, and creating a strong foundation for our school's future. Your belief in the power of education and your commitment to our mission are truly commendable. Thank you. To the school leadership team, I want to extend my deepest appreciation for your remarkable leadership and dedication. Your visionary approach, passion for education, and commitment to our pupils has been truly inspiring. Your guidance and support have been crucial in shaping our school policies, programs, and initiatives. You have been the driving force behind our achievements, and we are grateful for your guidance and the extraordinary work you have done to create a nurturing and stimulating learning environment. Thank you. Next, I would like to express my gratitude to the SCIS parents, who are led ably by the chair of the Friends of St. Christopher's, Mrs. Mathoni Mugo. Your support, active involvement, and enthusiasm have made a significant difference in our school community. Your dedication to the well-being and success of our pupils is invaluable. Through your initiatives, fundraisers, and volunteer work, you have enriched our school experience and created a strong sense of unity and collaboration. Your partnership with the school has played a vital role in creating a supportive and inclusive environment for our pupils. Thank you, parents. Lastly, but certainly not least, I want to extend a heartfelt thank you to our incredible teachers. Your passion, expertise, and commitment to nurturing the minds and hearts of our pupils are truly admirable. Your tireless efforts to provide quality education, inspire creativity, and ignite the love of learning have made a lasting impact on our pupils' lives. Your patience, dedication, and ability to go above and beyond have not gone unnoticed. You are the guiding lights in our pupils' educational journey, and we are immensely grateful for your hard work, passion, and unwavering dedication. Thank you, teachers. No discussion on togetherness would be complete without mentioning Martin Luther King Jr., who famously said, "We may have all come on different ships, but we're in the same boat now." His words echo the importance of unity, equality, and understanding. Now that we are on this boat together, let us continue to embrace the spirit of adventure, curiosity, and unity. The journey ahead may be filled with unknown challenges and exciting opportunities, but let us embark on it with the same sense of wonder, enthusiasm, that we have shared within the walls of our beloved school this year. Just as Julia Donaldson's books taught us the value of teamwork, our collective accomplishments have been the result of collaboration and support. We have worked together in classrooms, on sports fields, in co-curricular activities, and in countless moments of friendship and camaraderie. These memories you have created together will be cherished for a lifetime, serving as a reminder of the strength and resilience that lies within us all. Finally, St. Christopher's, remember that you are all part of a remarkable community that will continue to support and celebrate your achievements. Congratulations on successfully completing another chapter in your educational journey. May your future endeavors be filled with joy, growth, and the knowledge that you are never alone, for we are all together on a journey. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Gibbons. Another excellent speech. Dear St. Christopher's International School family, friends, and community. On behalf of the Board of Directors, I welcome you all this morning at the successful conclusion of yet another academic year in our long history. It gives us such joy and pleasure to see the school navigate successfully and even triumphantly in many ways the challenges and demands of daily educational life. And for this, we give glory to God Almighty. I would like to thank all of you, students, and all of you, parents and parent leaders, without whom we would not have anyone to teach, to educate, to guide, to shepherd. Thank you all. We also give our most special thanks to and for all of the staff of SCIS. There is so much that goes into the running of a successful school. And much like the seemingly serene swan upon the lake, underneath we are constantly swimming hard to ensure that everything is working as it should. From the askaris at the gate and within, the drivers and mechanics, the ground staff, the farm staff, the kitchen staff, the boarding staff, the cleaners and all auxiliary staff, the administrative staff, the IT staff, the teaching and teaching support staff, the teaching and management heads, the deputies, the heads, our executive head, Mr. Gibbons, and my fellow board members, led by our chair, Mrs. Leanghini. Without each and every one of you, just as without the students and the parents, there is no school. And so I truly thank you all. Thank you. This year marks our first full return to school without COVID restrictions. Dr. Jackie? And the true new normal, not living without COVID, as it is still very much in circulation, but living with it in mind, sometimes masking up, showing each other grace when unwell, but pushing forward nonetheless. We are truly a resilient generation. As a school, we have faced many challenges and have come through them all. Inspections by ministries of education and health, which we are duty bound and happy to comply with, and glad and grateful to pass each and every time. Having previously had our Council for International Schools inspection online, as Mr. Gibbons mentioned, this year we had our first in-person international inspectors visit from the UK. We are exceedingly and rightfully proud of the excellent rating they have given our school. And it seems that they too fell in love with our Kenyan warmth. Bravo to our entire school community. You all had a hand in that achievement, and I would love it if you would give yourselves a round of applause. Normally at speech day, the board will give an update and a way forward on capital developments. But this year, and today, I will only mention one, that we have seen the final completion of the MPB building with the opening and operation of our fantastic Semper Fit gym. Why Semper Fit? Because our motto at St. Christopher's School is Semper Excelsius, always higher, and therefore Semper Fit, always fit. This is a call to our determination to nurture in every one of us, not just a healthy mind, but a healthy body too, and a healthy lifestyle. This is a journey that we will all walk together. Some of us need more encouragement than others. And we look forward to opening the gym doors to parent membership very, very soon. We give praise to the Almighty and thanks to all our development partners and teams for all that we have been able to do and for what we will achieve in the future. With regards to the other developments that we have done before, I think that I will let the words of CIS speak for us. When it came to the evaluator response in our school report, the examiners said, the inspectors said, the students and staff at SCIS benefit from a clean, attractive and spacious environment that is enhanced by the high quality of displays both inside and outside classrooms, celebrating student achievement, inspiring peers and informing teaching and learning. There is little doubt that the well-maintained facilities, resources, and equipment boasted by the school are supportive of high-quality teaching and learning. And there are exciting redesign and new build plans in place, referenced in the school's narrative and evidence, to enhance the quality of the environment still further, including the new gymnasium. Good use is made of the space available, with some excellent adaptations of common areas in recent years, allied to some innovative thinking to enhance the existing environment, to reflect African themes and culture. We thank CIS for truly seeing SCIS for who we are. Even as we have overcome much, we must not rest or grow weary. But in the wise words of Dory, the forgetful fish in Finding Nemo, we must just keep swimming. These are not easy times. The economic hardships that we have endured and continue to endure are well known to all of us. We have overcome political uncertainty and now face political assurance that economic hardship will bite harder still, and especially so for employers in personnel-heavy professions and industries such as our own. Our resilience must endure. The world is a very different prospect now than it has ever been before. I feel like this could be said every year, but this year I am continuously pondering the nature of truth and what it means, if anything. In a world full of endless propaganda, spin, and personal truths, is there really such a thing as truth? I am reminded of the English journalist and poet Rudyard Kipling, who lived in a time of war and great trouble, and at such a time wrote a poem entitled A Legend of Truth, which begins, "Once on a time the ancient legends tell, truth rising from the bottom of her well, looked on the world, but hearing how it lied, returned to her seclusion, horrified." The entire poem makes very interesting reading, especially in today's world context. In a world of uncertainty, it is easy to retreat in horrified seclusion, to withdraw, overwhelmed. Yet I would encourage us all to keep going, because the history of the world is still a story of hope. Humanity has endured atrocities, heinous sins, and calamities before, and continue to endure. We are a generation that has survived a global pandemic, and though we have lost much loved family and friends, still we endure. In this world, there is a beacon of truth, of hope, and of love. The Lord God Almighty, in whom we continue to put our trust, is that steadfast mark, that strong tower, that lighthouse in a storm, that path in the desert, that stream of living water that we can draw from and find refreshment and strength and courage to prevail against the elements of the day. With apologies to Shakespeare for slightly amending his 116th sonnet, the love of God does not alter when it alteration finds, but it is an ever-fixed mark that looks on tempests and is never shaken. We must never despair nor be discouraged. On the contrary, we must rise to every challenge, strengthened and emboldened by the Lord Jesus who redeems us, the Holy Spirit who lives amongst us, and our Lord God who remains the truth from everlasting to everlasting. St. Christopher's International School is facing a challenge at the moment in the form of a government policy that may seek to compel us to surrender an integral part of our school grounds to the development of a commuter railway to connect the station near Lenana School to Ngong Town and beyond. We have engaged Kenya Railways on this matter. We had a meeting with them last week. And we have sent communication to each and every parent informing you of this. We have also sent out word to our entire Karen community, as this would not affect not only us, but the whole of Karen. And we as a board have further engaged Kenya Railways on this. We had a first meeting here with them at school, as I said last week. And this morning at 7 a.m., I had a meeting with the managing director of Kenya Railways at the corporation offices. I would like to inform you all now that the meeting we had this morning was a very good meeting, a very conciliatory meeting. And we have reached agreement with Kenya Railways that they will engage us more. They are in the preliminary design stage of this commuter rail. The designs are not yet complete, and they are going to engage us with them in their design so that it will lead to the least disruption to St. Christopher's operations. The managing director also assured us this morning that the government has no appetite to acquire private land and wishes to use only public land for this purpose, and therefore we should not worry. Our response as a school and as a board was to say thank you, and we will continue engaging with Kenya Railways and with government as a whole, because we do support the development progress of our nation, which is for our benefit, but we must protect the school at all costs. It is in all our interests to assist the government find a better route, more efficient, more logical, and cheaper route to save them all money and save us all money and trouble. The Board of St. Christopher's is staunch in our support of the school, and we will not surrender the school's fields. And we do not want the government's money in recompense. We do not want the government's money, I say, but in truth, it is our money, because it is taxpayers' money. We are all taxpayers, and therefore stakeholders in the government. We have been greatly heartened by the response of all of you, our parents, and our neighbors, and our community, and our advocates, all of whom stand ready to walk with us down this path. When it comes to the illusory lure of compensation, we, as a board, tell them, in the words of Margaret Thatcher, the ladies are not for turning. A school is not just a collection of classrooms, books, instructions, and instructors. We are concerned about every aspect of the lives and health of these precious children that you entrust to us each and every day. We educate the whole child, not just their minds. The playing fields of St. Christopher's are every part as much a classroom as the buildings are. And with your support and the Lord with us and our actions when and where required, we will all prevail. Now, I'm sorry to have talked about dark things and dark times and difficult times. But in dark times, we all need encouragement too. And because I do have my father's poetic soul, and because he made me memorize it, so then I will give this back to you. I will close by taking us back to Rudyard Kipling in more hopeful mood. And the poem of advice that is perhaps his most famous, and certainly my favorite of all. I dedicate this poem to the entire SEIS community, and also to our very special graduating class of 2023. Class of 2023, you are going out into a world that you must not allow yourselves to be daunted by. You must forge your path ahead and never, ever give up. My dear graduates, do not be swayed by lies or fiction, but always seek the everlasting truth. Do not despair. This journey we are on is long, but it has great beauty and great meaning. And we must, each of us, seek out its meaning and our place in it each and every day. Hebrews 11:6 tells us that the God who rules and reigns over all is the one who rewards those who seek him. Let us long to seek God and find our reward in him. And now, this is If by Rudyard Kipling. If you can keep your head when all about you are losing theirs and blaming it on you. If you can trust yourself when all men doubt you, but make allowance for their doubting too. If you can wait and not be tired by waiting, or being lied about, don't deal in lies, or being hated, don't give way to hating, and yet don't look too good nor talk too wise. If you can dream and not make dreams your master, if you can think and not make thoughts your aim, if you can meet with triumph and disaster and treat those two impostors just the same, if you can bear to hear the truth you've spoken, twisted by knaves to make a trap for fools, or watch the things you gave your life to broken, and stoop and build them up with worn-out tools. If you can make one heap of all your winnings and risk it on one turn of pitch and toss, and lose, and start again at your beginnings, and never breathe a word about your loss. If you can force your heart, nerve, and sinew to serve your turn long after they are gone, and so hold on when there is nothing in you except the will which says to them, hold on. If you can talk with crowds and keep your virtue, or walk with kings nor lose the common touch, if neither foes nor loving friends can hurt you, if all men count with you, but none too much, if you can fill, excuse me, if you can fill the unforgiving minute with 60 seconds worth of distance run, yours is the earth and everything that's in it, and which is more, you'll be a man, my son, and a woman, my daughter. Thank you. I assure you that my address is over. It is now my happy duty to introduce to you our guest of honor today. If I was to give you her entire biography, we would be here the rest of the day without hearing her speak. Dr. Jacqueline Kitulu is an accomplished medical doctor and experienced board member offering over 15 years of executive and organization leadership in the healthcare sector, with expertise in corporate and organizational governance, board management, healthcare advocacy, and over 20 years of clinical expertise in patient care. She is the chairperson of Rocket Health Uganda, the immediate past first deputy governor of the Kenya Red Cross Society, the past president of the Kenya Medical Association, and most notably also, she was the first female to chair the Kenya Medical Association. She also chaired the Kenya Medical Women's Association and currently sits on several boards, including Emergency Plus Medical Services, Safaricom Health Advisory Board, PATH Kenya Board, and Tech Care for All Global Advisories Board. She has also completed terms on the following boards: the Kenya Medical Practitioners and Dentists Council, the National Hospital Insurance Fund, the Kenya Healthcare Federation, and the Kenya Consumer Protection Advisory Committee, and beyond. She is privileged to have served as a presidential appointee to the National Economic and Social Council, a high-level advisory body to the government of Kenya between 2008 and 2014, and for which she was rightfully awarded the honor of Order of the Grand Warrior of Kenya. She is also an MBA in healthcare management, an alumnus of Strathmore Business School, and believes that this has gone a long way in bridging the communication gap between her health background and her current policy influencing position in a build to transform the health sector in Kenya. Ladies and gentlemen, we are privileged today to have as our guest of honor, Dr. Jacqueline Kitu.
Thank you, Ms. Ohaga, for that amazing introduction. I'm also wondering who that person is. So good morning, St. Christopher's International School community. It's such a delightful day for me to be here and see the ones who are in the front here. It transports me many, many years back. But thank you very much for the invitation to speak during this special day in honor of academic excellence. I will not introduce myself further because Mrs. Ohaga has done a magnificent job of that. But I also want to mention that I have two sons. I am married, I have two sons, university going age. So one's 23 and the other is 20. So I can relate with a day such as this from the point of view of a parent. And I am really glad to finally be here at St. Christopher's, bearing in mind that I was the school doctor from about 2005, when it was in its previous location in Kilimani, until it moved to here in Karen. Since then, I have had this desire to come and visit the new campus, but I guess today was the day. And I am truly honored by this invitation. And what I have seen so far, I am truly impressed. So first of all, I would like to congratulate all the ongoing students who have excelled in their various subjects and to those who have endeavored to continuously improve their performances. You are on the way to greatness, so continue pushing forward. Special congratulations to the awardees who are the best performers, and especially to the graduating class of 2023. Indeed, you have done well and have made everyone proud. And it is for this reason that all of us are congregated here today to celebrate you and encourage you in the journey ahead. Nevertheless, this will be an end to a long journey that you have taken so far. But every new end presents a new beginning. And this is the beginning of a new journey for those who will be graduating from secondary school, as you will now start a new voyage into college or university or wherever else you may be going. And that's another stage of your academic life. So today we celebrate the culmination of your individual journeys. But let me remind you that no one ever truly journeys alone. Along the way, you've had family, friends, teachers and mentors who have provided guidance, motivation, and support for you. They have believed in you when you couldn't believe in yourself, and they have helped you to overcome the inevitable obstacles and challenges that come with every journey. As you move into this next chapter of your lives, remember that you are not alone. You are part of a larger community, and your success is intertwined with the success of those around you. You have the power to uplift and positively impact others, just as they have done for you. Remember that life is not a solo journey, but instead a rich tapestry of relationships and experiences that shape who you are. So as you begin your next chapter, go forth with confidence and pride. You are capable of greatness, and the world is waiting for your contributions. Let your journey be one of growth, learning, and service to others. As you venture out into the world, embrace the humbling journey of self-discovery and use it to create positive change. Do not let setbacks or failures discourage you, but instead let them push you forward, fueling your passion and drive to achieve your dreams. Many years back, and those are really many when I look at the ones who are in the front here, and still very many even when I look at the ones who are graduating. I graduated from high school in 1990, a long time ago. But many years back, in a not so different situation as you find yourselves in now, I sat just like some of you. I can see the ones seated here in school uniform, listening to countless speakers, wondering what the future held for me, and also wondering when lunch would finally be served. Regardless, I had one constant goal. I wanted to be successful. But what is success? We find success when we use and enjoy our God-given gifts and talents to the best of our ability and for God's purpose. The education you are getting now is important to this success and will prepare you for your future careers in whatever fields you will get into. And I know sometimes you ask yourselves why you have to go through so many of the subjects that you're doing today. And to answer this, I will read you an excerpt from a speech by President Barack Obama to young students much like you. And I relate to it, and I'm sure it still will be relevant to you today as well. So he said, maybe you could be a good writer, maybe even good enough to write a book or articles in a newspaper, but you might not know it until you write a paper for your English class. Maybe you could be an innovator or an inventor, maybe even good enough to come up with the next iPhone or a new medicine or vaccine, but you might not know it until you do a project for your science class. And maybe you could be a governor or a senator or a Supreme Court judge, but you might not know that until you join student government or the debate team. And no matter what you want to do with your life, I guarantee you that you will need an education to do it. You want to be a doctor or a teacher or a police officer, a nurse or an architect, a lawyer, you want to join the military, you're going to need a good education for every single one of those careers. You just can't drop out of school and drop into a good job. You've got to work for it and train for it and learn for it. So what is my story? I have been just like you seated right there, and my dream was to be a doctor to impact people's lives, change people's lives. I didn't see exactly how that was going to be, but yes, I went through high school, I got on to medical school. You know, those who have just graduated today, you're on top of it, you know, the prime of everything. And unfortunately with life, you're on the top of that, and then you go back down to being the bottom. And then you go to medical school and your first year and you're like, wow, this is tough, this is difficult. But there you made friendships and worked with the groups, and we supported each other. And we overcome that difficult medical school life of 6 years. And finished and did internship. So you finish into a medical school and think, oh, I'm at the top of it now. And then you go into internship and you realize you're the bottom of the pyramid again as a doctor, you know, junior doctor, and all the work is on you. But it's in that context of being in internship and seeing how much work needed to be done that I began to think, yes, I always thought about the difference I wanted to make to patients' lives, but I realized that I needed to do a little bit more to impact more people. And it was not enough just to treat one patient, but to think about influencing how the policy is made to treat everyone so that everybody could access some good care. And that is how I shifted into, well, not totally left practice, because I still do practice and my practice is up the road. I've seen some of you as children, I've seen some of the staff, I have seen many of you, and I continue to practice because that also grounds me and enables me to know what it is to offer care to an individual. But that propelled me to move into the areas of making a difference in policy settings. That's how I've been in the associations and sat on various boards and sat on policy-making bodies appointed by the president. again to make a difference to the whole of this country. So why do I share that? Because I want to encourage you to dream big and follow your dreams. You all have great potential within, and it takes you to believe in yourself to make it happen. Believe in your unique talents, skills, and abilities. You're capable of achieving greatness far beyond what you can even imagine. Embrace your individuality, for it's what sets you apart and allows you to make a difference in the world. This world does not need another Obama, or another Wangari Maathai, or another Dr. Kitulu for that matter. It needs unique individuals like you to make a difference, to innovate, to champion new ideas, and to make the world a better place. So what are my takeaway points for you? At whatever stage you are, whether you're in prep school, moving on to secondary school, moving on to high school, whichever point you are, number one, be different. Why do I say be different? Don't be afraid to challenge the norm. Be willing to take a chance, asking why, making your own track, not just following the well-trodden path, charting your own course and destiny, being the person that you are always meant to be. Two, you need to work hard. I'm sure you hear this all the time, and it will continue to apply all through your life. No one is born being good at what they do. You work very hard to perfect your skill. As a doctor, our training takes many years. So one can be good at what they do, and no matter how intellectually gifted one is, a lot of effort must be put into being the best physician to your patient. And this applies actually to any profession or any area where you're going to work in. I've seen the band playing out here. If they don't practice to perfect what they do, they'll just sound like a cacophony here. But because they practice and put effort into it, you have a beautiful noise coming through. So remember, the path to success is paved with countless hours of determination and effort. But embrace the grind and your dreams will become your reality. Three, cultivate a mindset of continuous learning and personal growth. So education does not end within the walls of institutions like this. It's a lifelong journey. So seek knowledge, explore new ideas, be open to different perspectives. And as you do that, embrace failure. I'm sure everyone tells you to embrace success. I want to tell you to embrace failure as an opportunity to learn, to grow, and to improve. Because failure does not define your future, does not define where you shall remain. It is an opportunity for you to learn. The greatest minds in history faced numerous setbacks, yet they persevered because they viewed each failure as a valuable lesson. So remember, the more you learn, the more you realize how much more there is to learn. So embrace curiosity and let it be the compass that guides you on your path to success. Three, build networks. And I think your theme today was being moving along together. So the friends you have today are bound to be your team in years to come. I am a proud member of my high school alumni association, where I'm actually the patron. And in that alumni association, the diversity is amazing. We have a governor, principals, secretaries, bankers, teachers, engineers, hoteliers, nurses, hairstylists, swimming teachers, ICT experts, nutritionists, farmers, HR practitioners, lawyers, real estate investors, politicians, cabinet secretaries, public prosecutors, you name it. We have them in that alumni association. What a powerful network. So that at any point, if there is anything that was a crisis and was required, I can look back into that network. So maintain contact with your fellow peers and join the alumni group of your class or your school. A former classmate or a schoolmate in the world can really open your doors. So it may feel like I have given a lot of information with you today, to share a lot of information with you today, but applying these words in your actions will not only benefit your future, but help bolster character, integrity, and promote personal growth within yourselves. And lastly, but not least, respect your parents, the adults around you, and really all of humanity. It costs nothing but earns so much more. Service in humility, may that be a guiding light. Thank you, and may your journey be filled with purpose, joy, and boundless success. God bless you.
Thank you, Dr. Kitulu, for that inspirational speech. Just to echo Mrs. O'Haga's words, it's an honor and privilege to have you here. Could you give her another big round of applause? Now we now move on to the next segment of our ceremony, and that is the prize giving. We will start with acknowledging our academic prize recipients. And again, I'll ask Dr. Kitulu to please come forth and help us award different prizes. To start with are the Preparatory Progress Prize winners. Now, these prizes go to those pupils whose sustained effort has enabled them to make the highest value added onto their targets that the teacher set for them at the beginning of the academic year. And that means term one, term two, and term three. So what I will do is that I'll call out all prize recipients for the Progress Awards. They will receive their prizes and will applaud them at the very end. So to start with, from year 1S, we have Jeshuran Mwangi. 1C, we have Grayson Kinaro. 1K, in absentia, we will recognize Kelly Siabei. From 2S, we have Wamboi Musimenta. From 2C, we have Ayman Mushanga. From 2K, Tyler Mando. 3S, Neema Kimani. 3C, Tunu Gedenji. 3K, Osike Nyokangi. 4S, Jaspan Joroge. 4C, Liam Asimas. 4K, Tana Mando. 5S, Adora Nganga. 5C, Vincent Omuga. 5K, Jabali Shaunda. 6S, in absentia, we have Ivan Muturi. 6C, Elion Makanda. And 6K, Natasha Baraza.
Please.
Okay, thank you. Let's give them one last big clap. Now, next, we move on to our form prize. This prize goes to the pupil who is an all-round student and whom all their peers look up to. So in essence, a pupil who is a great role model to their peers. And so the form prize recipients are as follows. From year one S, we have Isabella Achola. Let's clap at the very end. We'll clap at the end. From year one C, Riri Karaoke. 1K, in absentia, Liam Masiga. 2S, Sean Kinyanjui. 2C, Neema Kwe. 2K, Kamara Karaoke. 3S, Mitch Onyango. 3C, Nathaniel Kamau. 3K, Amelia Swao. 4S, Trinity Kanyata. 4C, Alexa Ambulwa. 4K, Ndungu Karaoke. 5S, Nia Gedinji. In absentia from 5C, we have Brandon Gitonga. 5K, Paula Karanja. From 6S, Peter Musebe. 6C, Naila Arudo. And 6K, Mavo Mugo. Okay, let's give them one last round of applause. Thank you. At this moment, I want to invite my colleague from the secondary school, Mr. Obo, to come and take us through the next segment. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Ms. Haimia. We want to continue in the same spirit of awards and preparing us that we have around 10 different categories of award from now that we are going to have at this moment. Now we're going to continue with the same trend of the Progress Awards and the Form Prize Award, and we also have other awards that I will be able to mention as we reach those particular awards. And so the Progress Award, just as Ms. Haimi has mentioned from for the prep, this award goes to students who have shown consistent improvement in different subject areas that they do. And we do this by tracking their progress based on the entry point and the grades that they score in each and every assessment that they do. And so this having been tracked throughout the academic year of 2022-2023, we have the following award winners under the Progress Award category from year 7. So year 7C, we have Ahava Washuli. 7S, Alexandria Gishui. I'll kindly request that we applaud at the end. And so I'll read all the names in the key stage 3, and then we upload at the end. 7K, Lucas Juguna. 8C, Kathrima Kinya. 8S, Sisia Wakulo. 8K, Jeremy Barasa. 9C, Trinity Mbithi. And 9S is Tajeu Milian. Next is Alexandra Gishui. Next, Lucas Juguna. Next, Kathurima Kinya. Then Sisia Wakulo. Then Jeremy Barasa. Trinity is not there, so next 9S is Sajeo Milian. Now it is the time to give them a big hearty round of applause. Thank you. For Key Stage 4, that is year 10 and 11, the same Progress Award goes to 10C, Joy Kamau. 10S, Sasha Mbuvi. Then 11C, Jennifer Muga. And 11S, Ashley Ochieng. Then Jennifer Muga. Then Ashley Ochieng. Again, a big round of applause for that group. Key Stage 5, which is the last group under Progress Award. Key Stage 5, that's year 12 and 13. Year 12C, the award goes to Juliet Diego. 12K, Shirley Limo. 12S, Miles Imbai. 13C, David Mwanzia. And 13S, Emmy Kariuki. Then Shirley Limo. Followed by Miles Imbai. Year 13, David Mwanzia. And lastly, Emmy Kariuki. Again, for the whole group, a big, hearty round of applause. For all the Progress Award winners, I want to say congratulations to you all and may your stars keep shining. The next award category is Form Prize Award, and this is a pass-through award or a value-based education award, also referred to as citizenship award or award about contribution to the school as a whole. Now this award goes to students who have greatly contributed towards the overall performance of their form room or of their class and have therefore gathered the highest number of merits. It's something we call merit competition. Based on any small good thing that a child does, the teacher always gives a merit. And so these particular award winners have gathered the highest number of merits for the academic year 2022-2023. From year 7, C, we have Palisa Joy. 7S, Amanda Kariuki. 7K, Kiera Ludenyi. 8C, Malik Washira. 8K, Eli Ayimba. 8S, Abby Mukindia. 9C, Emmy Forbes. And 9S, is Shoshi Walisho. Then Amanda Kariuki. Then Kiera Ludenyi. Malik Washira. Eli Ayimba. Then Abby Mukindia. Then Emmy Forbes. For Kids Age 4, same form prize award. Year 10C, Timothy Modi. 10S, Malkia Washira. 11C, Sisi Ademba. And 11S, Ashley Mutonga. Malkia Washira. Ceci Ademba. Then lastly, from year 7 is Ashley Mutonga. Key stage 5, year 12 and 13. 12C, Sean Dagger. 12S, Stacy Waliaula. 12K, Charlie Limo. 13C, Natasha Comfort Nganga. 13S, I'll still remind us that we upload at the end. 13S, Matania Imbai. Then Natasha Comfort. Then Matania Imbai. May we applaud them? Well done to all the Form Prize Award winners. It's actually about St. Christopher's warmth. And so I want to say, may you keep sharing the St. Christopher's warmth even beyond. The third category is Subject Award winners. Now, this is an Academic Excellence Award or Achievement Award. And for this time, we're going to focus on the candidate classes, that's the year 11 and year 13, because the rest of the other classes we did award yesterday. And so this is an achievement award that are given to students who have exhibited exceptional academic performance in various subjects during the 2022-2023 academic year. For this category, we will award, as I've mentioned, only the year 11 and the year 13, the candidate classes that did the Cambridge examination. And so from year 11, the subject award for music and GCE O-level English language goes to Notando Muhiriro. Physical education goes to Joshua Kula. Religious studies, economics, and business studies goes to Benjamin Kagua. Mathematics, art and design, and geography goes to Ashley Ochieng. Chemistry, physics, information and communication technology, as well as biology shared together with Ashley Ochieng, goes to Hope Buto. Literature in English, Swahili, first language English, goes to Ashley Mutonga. Drama and history goes to Ceci Ademba. Foreign language, French, goes to Jennifer Muga. Food and Nutrition, Grace Ngigi. travel and tourism, as well as global perspectives and research, goes to Kinan Ayimba. And lastly, from year 11, sociology goes to Jaden Kiplagat. Starting from Notando, Joshua Kula, Benjamin Kagwa, Ashley Ochieng, you may need some support, Ashley. Hope Buto, Ashley Mutonga, Ceci Ademba, Jennifer Muga, Grace is not there, so Kinan Ayimba, and Jaden Kiplagat. Again, a big, big, hearty round of applause for them. The same category of subject award, excellence award, that's the academy, subject achievement award for year 13 for law and sociology. The award winner is Natasha Comfort Nganga. English language and geography, Amy Kariuki. Global Perspectives and Research, Maria Nduba. Chemistry and Biology, Mark Washira. Physics, Michael Muga. Computer Science, Michael Chesang. Psychology, Olivia Thiong'o. Mathematics, Zipora Gatambia. Music, Mwendwa Masika. And lastly, in that category, BTech Business and IT Diploma, Tendai Muhiriro. So starting from Natasha Comfort, Amy Kariuki, Maria Duba, Washira. Olivia, Olivia Thiong'o. Zipora Gatambia. And Mwendwa Masika. Well done to all the Subject Award winners. May you go and conquer the world. At this point, I would like to welcome back Mr. Gibbon to give a special award to a special group. Then I will come back with the trophy awards.
Thank you very much, Mr. Bo, and well done to those people so far. Now is a good opportunity for our guest of honor to rest her legs, a much needed rest, and for Mr. Bo to rest his voice. Because in a moment, when they come back on, we of course have the final trophy presentations to be awarded. But if you are eagle-eyed and you were here last year, you will notice there is a new addition to the program. And for those of us that are here this morning, we are going to be witness to a new tradition at St. Christopher's, and one that is hugely significant, and it involves our senior pupil leadership team. We've seen and heard a lot from the current senior prefects over the last few weeks, and I would like to invite them all one last time up onto the stage. So our head girl, Amy Kariuki, head boy, Mwendwa Masika, and our head of school, Mark Washira, please make your way up. I didn't quite predict they were going to get the reception they did. I had a whole thank you planned as you made your way up. I'll do it anyway. So, as they make their way up, I would like to take a moment to express my heartfelt gratitude and admiration for the incredible work that you have accomplished during your tenure as the senior pupil leadership team. Your unwavering dedication, enthusiasm, and exceptional leadership have made an indelible impact on our school community. Under your guidance, we have witnessed remarkable growth and development in various spheres of pupil life. Your innovative ideas, tireless efforts, and collaborative spirit have transformed our school into a thriving and inclusive environment where each pupil feels valued. The progress we have achieved together is a testament to your remarkable vision and commitment to excellence. Throughout the term, you have exemplified true leadership qualities. Your ability to inspire and motivate others, coupled with your impeccable organizational skills, has facilitated the successful execution of your duties. As you now hand over the reins to the incoming pupil leadership team, I have every confidence that they will inherit a legacy of excellence and inspiration. Your exceptional achievements and the positive impact you have made will serve as a guiding light for future leaders. Your dedication and passion have set the bar high, and I have no doubt that the incoming team will rise to the challenge and continue to build upon the solid foundation you have established. You can see I thought you were slow walkers. Can we please give them a round of applause one more time? Their tenure is now over, and the new bit of tradition that we are now going to witness will be the handing over of their ties, which therefore hands over the roles and the duties that carry with them. So it now gives me great pleasure to announce our incoming senior prefect team for 2023-2024. I will read them out individually. Now I'd like them to come up immediately and receive their ties from the outgoing team. I will begin with our incoming head girl for 2023-2024 is Jeanette Nandwa. Our incoming head boy for 2023-24 is Amani Macharia. And rounding off the trio and leading the school through next year, our head of school for 2023-24 is Ashley Ronno. Pupils, you are in good hands. Thank you again, outgoing team, and welcome the new team. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. The last category of awards, are the trophy awards. And so we have seven different subcategories. So the first trophy award is what we call All-Round Academic Excellence Award. And this goes to the student who has scored high quality grades consistently from term one to term three and even previously. And so this academic year, All Round Academic Excellence Award goes to Natasha Comfort Nang. That's a highly competitive award, and that's why you can see the emotions attached to it, because it's highly competitive. The next trophy award is the Davidson Ngini Interhouse Cup Award. Now, this award is in recognition of the House of the Year, referring to the house that emerged top in inter-house competitions and therefore has the highest overall merit tally. It simply means that each and every child in that house has contributed to this. And so this year's Davidson Nginni Interhouse Cup Award goes to Chewy House. I will ask the Chewy House captains, the two of them, to come. And like, just as I've said, every single student effort goes into this. All their aspect of school life goes into this. Academics, sports, merit, and the general well-being goes into this. And so, well done, Chewy House. May we give them a big, big, hearty round of applause. The third trophy award is the John O'Haga Trophy for Boys Sports. And this goes to the boy who has displayed an outstanding sportsmanship throughout the academic year. And this trophy goes to Joshua Kula. Well done, Joshua. The same way, we also have trophy for girls, same merit, and this goes to Felika Chengshon. The third last trophy is the Creativity and Performance Excellence Award. Now, this award is given to a student who has exhibited outstanding performance and creativity. And the winner for this year's Creativity and Performance Award is a student who actually winning it for the second time. And this student has consistently performed in all the school events. It's a very, very excellent, if not outstanding, violinist. Is an active member and continuing member of Safaricom Youth Orchestra. And so the award winner for the Creativity and Performance Excellence Award for the year 2022-2023 is Mwendwa Masika. Well done, Mwendwa. The second last trophy is Doreen Manning Cup Award. This particular trophy was donated by the founding head teacher, Doreen Manning, and is awarded to a student who has shared the warmth of SCIS and has contributed in different ways to the school life and created a positive impact within the school community. This year's Doreen Manning Cup Award goes to Amy Karaoke. Well done, Amy. The last trophy award, a very, very special award, is the Head Teachers Award. Like I've said, it's a very special award given in recognition of a student who has contributed in, again, different aspects of the school life, a lot of focus on the leadership, support of other children, mentorship, and is outstanding again in different aspects of the school life. And so this year's Head Teachers Award goes to Mark Washira. As we conclude the award category and almost coming to an end, I would like to invite the incoming head of school, Ashley Rono, and the current head girl, prep school, Marvel Mugo, to come up front and give a special award to our guest speaker. To our guest speaker, we want to say thank you. It's just a different way of appreciating the work and the time that you've taken to be with us today and even in your preparation. May you receive the little gift that we give as SEIS family. Thank you so much, Dr. Jacqueline. As we come to the end of this, I would like to invite the chair of St. Christopher's, Friends of St. Christopher's, for a word, and finally to close this with a word of prayer.
Thank you, and congratulations, everyone. I'll just echo the words of our guest speaker, Dr. Kitulu. Embrace failure too. Even if you didn't get an award, failure is an opportunity for you to learn and to do better and to come here another time. Thank you so much, mostly to parents, for turning up for this event and for always showing us as the parents' leaders a lot of support. And just before I close with a prayer, I'd like to thank the board for the issue of the Kenya Railways construction that has been handled with so much grace. Thank you so much, Mrs. Ohaga. Thank you for meeting with them. Thank you for making this process amicable. And I really also want to thank Mr. Gibbons, because as soon as this news came that they were coming on the ground, he called us immediately and he did not hesitate to inform us of how grave the situation was. I also would like to thank my committee, the Executive Committee of Friends of Christopher's, of St. Christopher's. Thank you for burning the midnight oil on this and working tirelessly to put our document together. And special thanks to Rabal and Company Advocates for finalizing it and giving it a very polished look, which you will see when you go to sign the petition at the banda behind the tent. Before you take your tea, please sign the petition. We are reaching for an amicable conclusion to this solution, to this problem. However, we would like to go all out in all means. So our petitions will still go on. Our school management will still continue engaging the Kenya Railways and all the other people. And we are going to also keep up with prayer, because at the end of it all, God has the final say. Please let us rise and say a word of prayer. Everlasting God, we thank you as we come to the end of this academic year. We thank you because you have sustained us. We thank you because we are in good health this morning, this afternoon, God. And as we come to the close of this term, we thank you, God, for all the awards that have been received by students here. We thank you for all the achievements and abilities and different talents that you have given them. We acknowledge that, God, they come from you, Father. We pray for excellence of all the students in this institution. In their areas of gifting, O God, may you help them to blossom and to be recognized in those, Father. We pray that they will have a good break, Father. Help them to have meaningful activities for the holiday. Help them to have rest. Help them not to engage in any bad company and bad behavior, Father. Please return them in September when they are healthy and when they are ready to learn, O God. We thank you for the parents in this institution, Father. Amidst economic crisis, O God, you continue to stabilize us financially. We acknowledge that we do not have anything good that did not come from you, God. And we pray that you're going to give us more financial stability and help us, Father, run this school financially even without any hiccups, O God. We pray for divine provision, O God. We thank you, God, for our teachers. Provide for them in ways that are beyond their imagination, O God, and enable them to be encouraged, Father, to come back and to continue with the good work that they are doing in this school. We honor you, God. We glorify your name. In Jesus' name I pray.
Amen.
Thank you. We may resume our seats. And so we've come to the end of this year's speech day. I want to appreciate each and every one of us for the time that we spent to be here. And as we come to the end, I just want to ask that the students, we just stay the way we are as we allow the guests led by Mr. Gibbons, followed by the parents, we can exit the back and kindly join us for a cup of tea at the top banda. Top banda is just right behind me here as we remain here as students. And as we do this for the parents, I just want to remind you that the term three reports are already shared and all of them will be shared by 2 p.m. today. So please, if you need to review and see what has happened for this term, you're free to interact with that report. Otherwise, may God bless each and every one of us. And for the students, may you have a peaceful and a restful summer breaks.